I'd like to welcome all of you to Pitch Camp. Thanks for joining in on a Thursday evening 4 p.m. session. This session has been very specifically curated in discussion with our speaker today, Amit Agarwal. I've known Amit for last a year or so, when I've been researching a lot about sales for tech startups, and how do we build this, how do we help our community of entrepreneurs and business owners and sales professionals enhance their sales quotient. And that's when I stumbled upon Amit's book, The Ultimate Sales Accelerator, and I found he brought in a very unique perspective of how to look at sales, that not just as a job that one does as a sales professional or as a responsibility that an entrepreneur does to grow his or her organization, but what does it take to actually own the growth and around your business and around your personal life as well, and using sales as a ladder to uplift yourself both emotionally and from a monetary point of view. So when we were putting this Pitch Camp sales leadership series, Amit was on my target list of speakers to put in, and finally reached out to him, and I'm very glad that he accepted to be on Pitch Camp. He's a very busy man. He's a senior vice president at Manthan, leads global sales and business development there. And since he's an also author, he also runs his own series of webinars and talk shows and all that. So welcome Amit, without further ado.
Thank you very much, Bimlesh. Very excited to be part of Pitch Camp and this session. Thank you folks for joining in. Welcome you all on Thursday afternoon at around 4 p.m. So these are some of the guidelines I would request you to, if you have a pen and notepad handy, please have it. If you want some 1 minute of time, please get it, because you will be doing some exercise. If possible, please use headphones. Otherwise, the speaker is also okay, because there would be some music and some meditation playing, which will be useful using headphones. Videos will be streamed. If you have any problem, ping us and we will give you the URL. Also, there are some exercises in which you might have to close your eyes. So please, that will help you in immersive experience. And while this says that Q&A in last 10-15 minutes, this style of discussion which I have is more interactive. So I will be asking questions, and I would request you to participate, because when we participate, the more possibilities open up. So on that note, I hope everybody has got a notepad and a pen handy. If the answer is yes, please type yes in your window. Or if you need some time, you get it, please. Okay, thank you very much. So we're good. So now with that, let's start with the first poll. What does emotional quotient mean for a person? So you please, 10 seconds more.
Yeah, we want this to be extremely engaging. So please participate in these polls. It will help you help everyone else.
Let's see the results. So we have 9 people who have given the votes, out of which 89% says ability to be sensitive and equanimous in all situations, 11% are very intelligent and sharp person. Okay, thank you very much for everybody to vote for this. And then now, I have seen various definition of emotional intelligence or emotional quotient. The one which appealed the most to me is from University Michael, UCM. You can go to their website to know more about them. And the definition is, emotional intelligence is our human ability to perceive and understand beyond form and to behave and react sensitively in all circumstances, situation, events, towards everyone and everything, people, objects, etc., that we may encounter, by relying on our conscious and unconscious memories. This is the key: conscious and unconscious memories, and the positive and and or negative emotional charges contained in them. The key word is, while everybody would say sensitively, the key word is memories. Memories. We are nothing but bundle of memories. So this is the piece. Now, in sales, while I knew all of this, when did this appeal to me more in sales is that around 6 months before, after the COVID-19 thing had started, one of the person reached out to me on LinkedIn and then in a webinar also, and he asked the following. He said, I have read few sales book, listened to podcast, and I've tried implementing majority portion, but I failed to generate revenue for myself. So that I thought this is the time now to harness EQ. You know, because if you're already excelling in IQ, which is all the skills, but if your mind is not proper, then it will not work. So why is EQ important? You know, this is a diagram which I hope you remember. This is called, so you're correct. So this is called iceberg, and iceberg says that 10% of iceberg is to be seen. The bottom is 90%. And this is a very good metaphor or a symbol for human mind. You know, the conscious mind is only 10%, which we use for logic, all of that, correct? But the mind which we don't use, which is subconscious, is 90%, which is nothing but your memories, feelings, habit patterns, correct? Remember conscious and unconscious memories? So this is what is, so EQ, what it does, EQ is here. So EQ is actually a larger portion. And that is the reason why it is important. Okay, yeah, you remember I said I will be asking a lot of questions, but it will be easy so that we can understand each other, you know, because I can't see you right now. That is the reason. Thank you very much. Okay. So now the question is why both EQ and IQ are needed for sales excellence. You will say, you know, I know storytelling, I know sales process, I know when to pitch, I know the new age sales tool. Those are all IQ. Why EQ is required, correct? So let's look again a good metaphor. So you know, you see this, what is this? A beautiful house, correct? External of the house is very beautiful, correct? Now, as you see this house, you will want to enter it, you know, and you, as you enter the house, you know, if the house is internally like this, beautiful, wow, wonderful. But then if you go to other house and you see that internally, it is like this. Externally, it is like this. Would you want to stay in that house? Yes or no? If you enter a house which is beautiful like this, internally it is like this, would you want to stay in that house? Okay, no. Okay. And so that is what it is, you know. External is IQ. All the skills which we use, sales process, all of that is IQ. Internally, how we feel about things, you know, how all of that is EQ. Correct? I actually guarantee if you stay with this session and only do one thing, only participate, do nothing else, you know, participate, correct? Then by the end of this, the three topics which we are covering here of EQ, you will become master in it. Guarantee. You will become 100% master in it. And you can, next time, Bimlesh can call you to take that session. I can guarantee you because it is actually very simple. The only thing is we have to just participate. Okay. Okay. With that, let's move on. So emotional quotient for excellence in sales. You know, so if some of you who have read my book, The Ultimate Sales Accelerator, in the chapter 2, I have introduced a structure called Mount Everest of Needs, you know, which is a very profound structure. You know, it can be used for anything in life. It is sales, it is anything. So in this case, I will use that structure, Mount Everest of Needs, for emotional quotient. Observe carefully. So first is Mount Everest of Needs. Needs are divided into two areas, service needs and unserviced needs. Service needs are known needs that are met. So I'll come to unserviced needs in a moment. So let's look at known needs that are met for emotional quotient. So what is emotional quotient which needs are met? So you have a job. Correct. So that's if you are in sales and you have a job, your service needs are met. You have colleagues, you know, that is also a need. So that is met. You know, that is a service needs. You, as far as EQ, remember, we are talking about EQ. We are not talking about IQ. So a job gives you security. Colleagues give you companionship. That is the EQ part. So that is service needs. Now let's go to unservice needs. Within that, first, known needs not met. So sometimes you may feel that whatever role you are doing is not appropriate. In that case, your internal, you know, is not aligned. Security, you might be feeling pressure or negative about job security. You might be lacking praise from your supervisors or your team members or your colleagues or even your family as far as, you know, your role is concerned. So that is no needs. Everybody wants a good role, wants to feel secure, wants to have praise from others. That may not be happening. Therefore, no needs not met. Are you with me till now? Yes or no? Yeah. Okay. Excellent. Now let's go to the no needs with resistance to change. Now this is the one in your case, you will want to feel empathetic. However, you may not feel it. You want to be empathetic towards somebody. You may not feel it. You want, it's not happening. Patience, you have sales goals, you have deals to chase. You want to close that deal. Everybody chase patience, sabri. They say, however, practicing it is very difficult because of this thing, resistance to change. Meditation, everybody knows meditation is good. You know, India is land of meditation. How many of us meditate? Embracing uncomfort, this is little interesting. Embracing uncomfort means doing something which is ethical and safe. Ethical and safe and uncomfortable. Ethical and safe and uncomfortable. Can you embrace that? It could be, actually, in some cases, meditation could be embracing uncomfort. Right? So the last one is self-praise. How do you talk to yourself? Do you demean yourself or you praise yourself? Self-praise. Now, a lot of times, you know, when I tell you, let me do this. If I tell you, you are great, what would you say? Most of the times people will say, no, I'm not great. You know, you are great. It is all because of you. What is it? You know, knowingly, unknowingly, we are demeaning ourselves. We are wired not to praise ourselves. That is the problem. This is because of resistance to change. And then unknown needs. This, you know, larger cost. So why are you in sales? Is it for incentive or is it for something else? You know, do you think that you can practice gratitude in sales? Do you practice visualization? How do you talk to yourself, self-talk? Do you forgive people, your clients, your colleagues, yourself? Is it easy for you to forgive? Storytelling is actually both IQ and EQ. One thing is both IQ and EQ. One thing is about doing only few things. One thing among so many. Service mindset. This is attached to the larger cost. Are you considering sales as an act of service or is it a job for you? Anchoring resourceful state. If I ask you, can you be resourceful right now? Right now. You know, if you get a chance, if we get a chance in the end, Bimlesh, I'm showing my, can you see my watch, everybody? Yeah. See my watch. In the end, if we have time, ask me, why am I wearing this watch? This watch. The answer lies in anchoring. I'll tell you how to anchor resourceful states. You know. Then 3S, which is Shraddha, Sabri, Sadhana. And then law of resonance, which is whatever we see outside, a percentage of it exists in us. If you see deals not closing, that means there is a percentage within you. You are not closing some deal. Some deal. So now this, as you can see, this can be a book in itself, at least 200 pages, correct? So I can't cover all of this right now, correct? What I can, I've given you an introduction, you know, and Bimlesh will share this deck also with you, correct? But I will cover three things out of this, which is gratitude, visualization, self-talk and self-praise together. I'm guaranteeing you, if you participate in this, you know, otherwise, you know, I tell this to a lot of people. When people attend sessions, you can do dating. It's like dating, which is instant gratification, correct? Then it is engagement, or it is marriage, or is it marriage with kids? I prefer sessions with marriage with kids. It's like having marriage and kids. That means you are going deep into relationship. For that, you have to show commitment, correct? And the simple commitment is participation. Now, we will take these three, gratitude, visualization, self-talk, and self-praise. I will be playing videos in each one of them, correct? If there is some problem, then you please ping. So we will start with gratitude. The first one is gratitude, correct? So have you heard of this term, whatever you appreciate, appreciates? How many of you have heard about this? Yes or no? You know, so this is a very thing. Whatever you appreciate, appreciates. You know? It's a very simple thing. Go and talk to somebody genuinely from all your heart, no sham, from all your heart, just praise that person from all your heart, you know, and then you will see magic happening. This is the easiest form of rapport building. I've written this in my book. Genuine praise is the easiest form of rapport building. However, today we are talking about gratitude, not only from rapport building, but from a higher purpose. So I will play a video now. Please watch this video, you know. I'll play for around 3 minutes. Please watch.
Okay, what can you do right now to begin to turn your life around? I'll tell you two or three things. Start making a list of things to be grateful for. Start with that, because this shifts your energy. It starts to shift your thinking. Where before this exercise, you might be focusing on what you don't have, and you might be focusing on your complaints, and you might be focusing on whatever the problems are. When you do this exercise, you start to go in a different direction. You start to be grateful for all the things that you feel good about.
Gratitude is absolutely the way to bring more into your life.
Every man knows that when his wife's appreciating him for the little things he does, what does he want to do? He wants to do more. It's always about appreciation. It pulls things in. It attracts support.
I've said for many years that whatever we think about and think about, we bring about.
Because that's that feeling that you have to have, you know. And so for me, it's been such a powerful exercise every morning to get up and say thank you. Every morning when I feed it before, thank you. And then I start running through what I'm grateful for as I'm going to brush my teeth and do the things I do in the morning. And I'm not just thinking about them and doing some rote routine, but I'm putting it out there and I'm feeling the feelings of gratitude. As soon as you start to feel differently about what you already have, you will start to attract more of the good things, more of the things you can be grateful for. Because you can look around and say, well, look, I don't have the car I want. I don't have the house I want. I don't have the health I want. I don't have the spouse I want. Back up, back up. Those are all the things you don't want. Focus on what you want. Have that you're grateful for, and also you might get sick.
Oh man, things aren't working right, or things are going bad, and there were some things going on in my family, and I found a rock. I just sitting here holding this rock. You might see me carrying around. I found a rock. I stuck it in my pocket, and I said, you know what? Every time I touch this rock, I'm going to think of something that I'm grateful for. And so every morning when I get up in the morning, I pick it up off the dresser, I put it in my pocket, and I go through the things that I'm grateful for. At night, what do? You empty your pocket. There it is again. And I've had some different experiences with that. I've had some amazing experiences. I had a guy from South Africa, and every time he saw me drop, he said, what is that?
Well, what's that?
I explained it to him, so he started calling it a gratitude rock.
Gratitude rock.
2 weeks later, I got an email from him from South Africa. He said, my son is dying from a rare disease, a type of hepatitis. He said, would you send me 3 gratitude rocks? They're just rocks I found off the street, you know? So I said, sure. I had to make sure that the rocks were very special. And so I went out to the stream, looked, picked out the right rocks, and sent them off to him. 4 or 5 months later, I get an email from him. My son's better. He's doing terrific. And he said, but you need to know something. He says, we've sold over 1,000 rocks at $10 a piece as gratitude rocks, and we raised all this money for charity. Thank you very much. It's very important to be in an attitude of gratitude, as I call it.
So if you see, you know, this is also research. I'm also showing you some research. It shows that happiness raises nearly every business and educational outcome, raising sales by 37%, productivity by 31%, and other tasks by 19%. This is an article from HBR, Harvard Business Review. Here we are talking about sales. Just by being happy or by expressing gratitude, you know, which makes us happy, 37% increase in sales. You can show it to your boss. So now this is an exercise. This is a time to take out your pen and pencil. So I will play the music 90 seconds exactly. Please have your pen and pencil or ready. And you have to write three things you are grateful in your sales career. And you have to write in first person. I am deeply grateful for whatever, because it has. It has to be in sales. Is it clear? Okay, excellent. So go ahead. I'll play this only for 90 seconds. You please start. Okay, would somebody want to share something in this particular exercise which we did? Does anybody wants to share what they are grateful for? One item in sales, this one. Yes. I am deeply grateful for ... because it has. Anybody wants to share? They say whatever you appreciate, appreciates. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, let me take a stab at it, Amit. Sure. I'm also considering myself as part of the audience today.
Absolutely. Yeah. 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 Go ahead. Yeah.
So I think, you know, I'm deeply grateful for the books that I've collected and read over the last 2 years, specifically on sales.
Yes.
And it has given me new knowledge, new perspectives, and new connections that I'm now able to implement.
Very nice. Very nice. You know, on that note, if I have to share something, I'm deeply grateful for getting experience of sales in startups, you know, because that has helped me understand, you know, internationally different countries, as well as creating business from ground up. That knowledge would not have been possible if it was not in sales and startups.
Right.
Okay. So Shiva, thanks Vimlesh. Shiva shares, I'm deeply grateful for helping prospect because it makes me happy. Wonderful. Thank you, Shiva. On that note, we'll move on. So this is the gratitude journal, which you can do yourself. The difference which I have done is that I have broken them down into different areas. So a lot of time we express gratitude, let's say, you know, three things I'm grateful for. This one, what it does is that it divides them. Okay, three things in personal life, three things in professional life, three things in financial life, three things in spiritual life, three things in my sales career. So you can choose this model. It will help you. Now there's a time for poll, vote on this. For practicing gratitude, which one item will you start with? Okay, say three things you are grateful for before sleeping. Excellent. Thank you very much. So the recommended book for this is The Magic by Rhonda Byrne. You can read this book. It is a very good book in terms of as far as gratitude practice is concerned. The second part is visualization. So I'll again play the video. Maybe you can share the link of the visualization video, Vimlesh, before I play. Yeah. If you have any problem, you can watch there. I'm started playing now. Yeah.
I think we start with relaxation techniques, putting your mind in a place where you can actually visualize effectively. I know when Michael was young, I gave his mom a book of progressive relaxation. And before he would go to bed at night, she would go in and read the progression of things to do, you know, like clench your fist, do, you know, take you through
whole, like you work through,
you
your,
work
whole
through your whole body. And actually it got so good. She just opened the book, say two things and he'd be asleep. He got really good at relaxing. So once you can put yourself in a relaxed state, then I tell them it's like watching a movie. So it's essentially what it is. Sometimes it's like you're sitting in the stands watching yourself swim. And sometimes it's like you're in the water swimming. The key to visualization is, number one, it has to be very vivid. It has to be rehearsed many, many times. And the reason it works is because the brain cannot distinguish between something that's really vividly visualized and something that's real. So by the time Michael steps up on the block to swim a race in a World Championships or Olympic game, he's swum that race hundreds of times in his mind before he gets up there. So then when he gets up, all he has to do is shut everything down and it goes on autopilot. His body automatically knows what to do. The brain just switches into what he's visualized. And that's what's really powerful about visualization.
When I would visualize, it would be what you want it to be, what you don't want it to be, what it could be.
Yeah.
So it's like you're always ready for anything that comes your way. So it's like if I would have a suit rip, fine. I need another suit. Put it on. You know, like any small thing that could go wrong, I'm ready for it.
Okay. What's the one thing that connected with you the most in this video? What is the one thing that connected with you the most in this video? See, the key word there is the brain can't distinguish between what is getting visualized and what is real. That is the key word. Yeah, so you are saying prepare for uneasy situation. Of course, the key word in this is the brain can't distinguish between what you are visualizing and what is real. That is the beauty of it. So if you visualize vividly something, then it becomes deeper in your subconscious mind. And the mind doesn't differentiate between what is real or unreal. You know? So therefore, in spiritual terms, it starts manifesting automatically. So this is the thing. Now, we will do a visualization exercise. I will first walk you through the steps. And then I will play it again. Okay, so right now, just see the steps. What will be the music will play. I will ask you to close your eyes. I will ask you to take 3 deep breaths, slow. I will then ask you to pick one specific deal you want to close. One specific sales deal you want to close. Then I will ask you, why is it important for you and your company? You will have to think about it. Then I will ask you to thank the client and everyone who has supported you in this deal till now. Then I will ask you to imagine you have received the signed contract for this deal. Experience it. What do you see? What do you hear? What do you feel? Take your time. Thank the client, your team, and universe who has helped you get this deal. And then I will ask you to open the eyes. Is it clear? This is very powerful, folks. You know, this is very, very powerful. You know, if you do it properly, magic can happen. Yeah. So I would request everybody other than me to close the eyes. So I can't because I am taking this session. So I'll play it, you know, just you have to listen to my instructions. Okay. Please close your eyes. As you close your eyes, take a normal breath in, very gentle and deep breath. Take another deep breath in and breathe out completely. One more gentle and deep breath in and breathe out completely. In this relaxed state, pick one specific deal or account which you are currently working on and you would want to close. As you think about that deal, think, why is it important for you? Why is it important for your company? Take your time. Take your time. Thank the client and everyone who has supported you in this deal till now. They could be your colleagues,
They could be your client team members, your supervisor, your seniors, anybody who has helped you till now in this deal. Please thank them with all your heart. Now, in this state of gratitude, imagine you have received the signed contract for this deal. You can experience that. What do you see as you? What do you hear? What do you feel? Experience it completely. You have the signed contract. What do you see, hear, and feel? Take your time. Take your time. Now, thank the client, your team, and universe who has helped you get this deal. Be grateful to everybody who has helped you get this deal. Whenever you feel complete, taking your own time in this state of gratitude, you may gently open your eyes. Amazing, Shiva says. Vimlesh, wonderful. Amit Srivastav says, relaxing for sure. Okay, excellent. Awesome. Niranjan says, awesome. Yeah, this is a 2-3 minute, you can call it very pleasant. Shivangani says, it's a very, very pleasant, very easy or pleasant meditation, which you can do. It is visualization and meditation together, correct? If you do it with these steps, you know, these very simple steps. Okay. So now, what is the best time for practicing visualization? If I ask you, what would you respond?
Anytime during the day.
Anytime is very nice. That is the correct answer. There is a specific time why it becomes, when it becomes more effective. When it is. Anytime, of course, you know, because visualization, which is a time when it can be more effective. Yeah. So the right answer for this is just you when you wake up or just before sleeping, your mind is more active because you are in sleep state, you know. So before bed and just before getting from bed, those are the two times, you know, when it is very, 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 very wonderful. So good, you guys got it. Now we are on the third part. You can practice it on your own later. Okay, excellent. Now with this self-talk and self-praise, so I'll play the video. You can share the link also, Vimlesh. Yeah, I'll play the video for self-talk and self-praise for 2 minutes.
It always amazes me and saddens me too that so many people I see put so much effort into trying to make someone love them by trying to change, when if they put half that effort into loving themselves, they would attract so much love. You see, when you're trying to change yourself, that means you must be criticizing yourself. I'm going to punish my body so it looks better. I'm going to put myself down in the hope that I will get better. I'm going to look at all my flaws and try to get rid of them. Don't be your own worst critic. Be your own best friend. What would you say to a best friend? Darling, you're amazing. Who cares if you got rid of Sally like that? That has nothing to do with how lovable you are. You're a great guy. You're interesting and funny, and any girl would be lucky to have you. You know what you would say to your best friend. Say that to yourself. Do not get sucked into being a critic. You know, so often I work on the radio, maybe I work with a big group, and I always want to give my group a takeaway. I want to give the audience something, some little thing they can do straight away that I know will change their life. And I always say to them, do not let in destructive criticism. Don't beat yourself up. Don't feel bad about yourself. Instead of criticizing yourself, praise yourself. I know for a fact there is nothing that can build you up the way self-praise does. Self-praise boosts your self-esteem, and criticism withers it and diminishes it. And good people praise, and people who feel bad about themselves criticize, because critics always have the most criticism reserved for themselves. Don't criticize yourself, praise yourself.
What is the one thing what is the one thing that connected with you the most in this video? What is the one thing which be your best friend, okay, Vimlesh? What about others? Always praise myself, okay, Niranjan? Be your best friend, Amit, okay? I would request others to please just write, let's not right and wrong answer, whatever you feel. Instead of criticizing yourself, praise yourself. What is very nice? Don't put down yourself. Very nice. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your responses. So, you know, this is a very famous author and very famous personality on self-development in US, Wayne Dyer, who says, our intention creates our reality, right? And the key thing is affirmation helps us create powerful intention. So look at it again. Our intention creates our reality, Wayne Dyer said. And then my experience tells me that affirmations helps us create powerful intention. And this, what is an affirmation? This I have taken from this book. Yeah, Bimlesh was mentioning about the importance of book. I also read books every day. So this is one of the book which I really like, Expand the Power of Your Subconscious Mind, which says an affirmation is a statement of fact or belief, positive or negative, that tends to lead you towards the end result you expect. That is an affirmation, you know, positive or negative, you see. So you can talk, when you say negative self-talk, it is putting yourself down. When it is positive, it is praise. So examples of negative affirmation or self-talk. My deals are not closing in sales. My pipeline is poor. I'm not making my incentive. If this is the way you are talking to yourself, then tathastu is happening. You understand tathastu? Tathastu? You understand that tathastu is not blessing. Tathastu is your wish is my command. Yes. Whatever you said is yes. If you say, you know, my deals are not going, tathastu. If you say that, you know, I am, you know, whenever I share content with my clients feel valuable. I share valuable content with my clients. Tathastu. So universe, there is a philosophy which says that there is a genie in the universe, which is only doing one thing. Tathastu, 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 tathastu. Whatever you are saying, tathastu. So that self-talk, you know, becomes so important. Did you get this or was it over the top, the tathastu concept? Did you guys get it? Yes or no? So these are the examples of negatives or affirmation or self-talk, you know. And, you know, nothing to feel bad about it. Even sometimes I, you know, think negatively. You know, we are human beings. At least most of us are not abhi nirvan nahi hua hai na sabka. We have not so we are human beings, correct? So we are vulnerable. If once in a while if a negative thought is coming, it is okay. The point is, has it decreased? And you know, after a while it will become zero. So the point is to acknowledge that there is a negative thought and it is not good. And once you acknowledge it, we can change it by using positive affirmations. So what are the examples of positive affirmations? I am a thought leader in. You can put whatever you are thought leader in. Great. You know, I continuously share insights that my clients find valuable. You know, as a presenter, I always present things that are of service to my clients. The first two are from my book, The Ultimate Sales Accelerator. Great. So you understand the difference between negative self-talk and positive affirmation? Yes or no? So now, there is an exercise for you. So before the exercise, this is a book I highly recommend. You know, I have myself done this. This is not a normal book. It is a workbook. It's a 21 days to heal your life. It is mirror work, you know. So a lot of times when we say affirmations, we talk to ourselves. The power of affirmation comes when you talk to yourself in the mirror, like this lady is doing. This book enables that. So it has every day one exercise which you do by watching yourself in the mirror. Fantastic. Fantastic. Highly recommended. Please, please do it. And after 21 days, you will be a different person. Guaranteed. You know, this is mirror work. And it is not academic. It is all practical. Whatever they say, you will have to practice it in form of mirror. So now this is an exercise, 90 seconds.
identify one negative affirmation that you use. Please write one positive affirmation that you can use daily in sales. You identify, and then identify one quality within you, and you write something to praise yourself in sales. So this is a exercise right now, 90 seconds. Please start. Okay, was everybody able? You can write about self praise if that helps better, you know, whichever. Okay, Shiva, adding value to clients always very nice, very nice, very nice. Thank you. This you know, this praising quality within yourself, if you focus on that, you know, Amit says, I have sound knowledge of my customer in my area, maybe late but will achieve. Very nice, Amit. You know, this is the way you are talking to yourself. I'm telling you, my friend, it is magical. All the skills, you know, all this, it's like saying, I'll give you an analogy. Imagine there is a soldier who is going to war, correct? He has all the best Astra Shastra, you know, the beautiful gun, everything. He has been trained properly, everything. And when he reaches there, he says, "Arey kahan aa gaya main? Thand mein, Ladakh mein? Arey ye mere boss ki inno ka dimag kharab hai. Kuch to wahan baithe rehte hain. Mere ko bhej diya. Aaj to main mar jaunga. Aaye to aaj to mera last din. Bhagwan bacha le. Aaj tumhe shaadi nahi hui, mujhe yahan bhej diya." To kya hoga uske saath? What will happen to that person? He is highly skilled, by the way. His IQ is very high, correct? Because he has been trained in warfare. For several years, he has qualified those exams and all of that, you know, those exams which are required. And yet, you know, if he feels, while the chances are very less in defense, you know, because their mindset is very strong. I'm just giving you an analogy that if suppose that person is thinking like that, he will certainly be killed that day only. Correct? So that is the power of self-talk, you know, that, and that is the reason a lot of times when people don't have proper weapons, correct? The way they talk to themselves, the energy power comes then within them, and they defeat people who are much powerful than them. That is called epic, memorable. Okay. So with that, if the question is for affirmations to be effective, the key thing is, so for affirmation to be effective, you can see the screen. You can type it now, either one or two in your screen. Repetition. Or do them occasionally. For affirmation to be effective, the key thing is what? Is it repetition or do them occasionally? What will you type? One or two? Okay, repetition. One. Very nice. So you know, see, if you have to have the affirmations to be effective, the only thing is you have to repeat them. You know, so if you repeat these kind of affirmation, like I am a thought leader in sales, I am a thought leader in you know, demand generation. I continuously share insight that my client find valuable. You know, whatever some of you said, if you keep on repeating that as a mantra, then you see what happens. So we are towards the end. The three EQ aspects we have covered today are gratitude, visualization, self-talk, and self-praise. You know, and I said you will understand it deeply. You will practice it. We have done all of that. You know,
And the one thing that you can do for the adoption is to make them a daily habit. You know? So I request you to practice them daily. That is the only thing which will help you: gratitude, visualization, self-talk, and self-praise. And these are the resources. I think Bimlesh has already shared these things with you. For me, if you are not connected with me on LinkedIn, you can please connect with me on LinkedIn.
Fantastic, Amit. Thank you so much for this. Very insightful, though it was just three topics.
Was
amazing.
Yeah, my wish for you before we start Q&A, my wish for you is this: may you harness the emotional quotient within you and be legendary salespreneurs. And let the music play. As the music is playing, the importance of emotional quotient is becoming more and more important for you. And you are on your path of becoming legendary salespreneurs. Thank you very much. With that, I'm open to any questions or doubts you have.
Shiva has a question here. When someone says you're great, how do you respond?
Oh, so the first thing is, whenever somebody praises you, or, first you have to say, you have to acknowledge it. Oh, thank you very much. The moment you say thank you very much, it's a direct acknowledgement. So you are great. How to respond? Thank you very much. I thank you for your appreciation. With the eyes and the mouth, if you say thank you very much, it doesn't work, because from inside you're not accepting it, right? Because you have been taught, a lot of us have been taught, that we are humble. If somebody says you are great, no, I'm not great, you are great. That comes very naturally. The first thing is to acknowledge. If somebody says, Bimlesh is saying thank you very much, Amit, I'm saying thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you very much. You are welcome, Bimlesh. Happy to be of service. Now, if I say, Bimlesh, if I do not acknowledge it, that is a problem. So the easiest thing is, Shiva, is to respond is thank you very much with your heart, and that will come through your face. And if you are not speaking to them, it will become your habit. If somebody says you're great, you will say thank you very much. You will automatically smile. See, right now I'm smiling, not knowingly. Correct? It is happening. It is happening. So that's okay. Thank you.
So let me ask you this question, Amit. Talk to us about some of your routines. At what times do you implement some of these things?
Yeah. So for me, as you, some of you might know that written in my book also, if you follow me on LinkedIn, I mention it, that I wake up at 5 a.m. And that happened from January 2nd, 2018. So the moment I wake up, before waking up, if there was a camera or if you came to my house, you will notice I'm sitting on the bed for around 15 minutes. So that is the time I exercise this. Now it has become a habit. So morning is an absolute habit. In the night, I tell my kids also, ki beta, sone se pehle teen cheeze jo achhi hui hai, din mein uske baare mein socho. What are the three things which has happened good? Okay. So those two things have become quite automated for me. The morning one is absolutely, because the moment I wake up, I don't come down the bed, correct? I'm in the bed sitting. So that's the key part of it, because when I'm, this is called active meditation, because when you are in that state, you're thinking about gratitude, you are actually also visualizing, if you see, and the way you are talking, like I am talking to myself. So all three, visualization, gratitude, and self-talk, is happening in that state.
Right.
That's very powerful. I've shown it as three. However, if you do it in the morning or in the night, in the morning, you are also fresh. Night, you might be tired sometimes. However, in night, it is more powerful, because when you sleep, your subconscious doesn't sleep. It is activated. Therefore, it is said that before sleeping, it is not advisable to watch anything negative, fighting and all of that, because that is all what is getting processed in your mind. So one thing I have to share with you, remember I
yes,
said,
come to watch.
This is the fourth item, although out of syllabus, since I mentioned it. So this is about harnessing resourceful states on demand. So what is the meaning of it? So this watch, what it represents for me, it represents a very, very complex and high price deal, which I got in 2016, around April, May, I got the contract. So in order to reward myself, when I got that contract, I said, I will buy something really. So I was at airport. On the airport, you know, that contract was with me. So I said, I have to buy something. So I was looking at it and I found this watch. Right? So this watch during that time was the thinnest watch. Now also it is might be the thinnest. You can see a double tone. And I really liked it. And so I took it. Now what it does is, you will notice every time I present, I will wear this watch. Every client meeting I go, I wear. What does it mean? It builds a very resourceful success anchor for me. You know, it reminds me of my own brilliance. It reminds me of my own. So these are things which are subconscious. You know, the moment I wear this, you know, the moment I wear this and I see this, my state is changed.
Right.
My state is changed. So there are so many things, as I said, you know, that a book can be written on it. But this is the fourth secret, which was not there. So you find something which is resourceful, which you find resource. Keep it close to you. Keep it close to you and you will build resourceful anchor. If you are unresourceful, you know, I might be so much tired before this call, but the moment I wear this and I do a self-talk, you know, then I get resourceful immediate. One more last one. If somebody had a question or something before we end the call. Yeah.
Yeah.
So Amit is saying, but I always like your morning post or takeaway from Gita. Yeah. I think the one which is we have to focus on process rather than outcomes. So that is, see, the main part of this is now in personal life and in corporate life is actually we are not doing things which either spiritually are correct. I'm not talking religiously, spiritually are correct, which is that you have to focus on process. You have to process and the outcome will automatically come.
Correct.
You know? Now, the problem is if you tell this to your boss, the boss might have a problem. But then you show Gita to him. And if he doesn't like Gita, then you show Mahendra Singh Dhoni to him. One of them they will like. And if he doesn't like anything, leave that boss. Yeah. Seriously. You know, personally to me, whenever somebody, you know, nobody has disagreed with me. They may delay that because they know what I am telling is correct. They may have a difference of opinion, but result is also. We are not saying result is not important. What we are saying is that rather than getting feverish about results, if you are feverish or if you are feverish about it, then nothing. You only get stress. If you are only focusing on, okay, if I have to close this deal, what are the three things I can do? You can say, okay, I have done everything. What is the one thing I can do now? So every time there is an action coming, that will make you resourceful rather than, you know, thinking, are meri deal nahi aayi. Remember that the self-talk, because that self-talk will come. Are my boss will say that. So we are continuously in negative self-talk. If we focus on process, if we focus on steps, action, then I think that puts you in resourceful state. I have seen people when they are in action, Bimlesh, you would agree with me. If you're not doing anything, suddenly depression comes or negative.
Correct.
If there is a deal and it is not moving and you're saying, okay, how can I get a meeting for my boss for that? You know, how can I share a valuable content which is of service to my client? Something or the other, maybe I have to do something differently. Rather than beating yourself, you are thinking of what you can do to help the client or to yourself or your team to close that deal. So that is the Amit that thanks for, observing that. And I know sometimes it may be difficult to implement. Only thing is slow is good. If you have first acknowledged it and appreciated it, you are on the right step, and slow steps you will take, you will achieve it. So that's,
thank you so much. Thanks everyone for engaging and for staying around for the entire duration. With this, we'll come to this webinar session close.
Thank you very much, Bimlesh. I hope it was service to others, you know, and, as you rightly said, these are little unusual topics, especially not discussed in context of sales, sometimes discussed in context of spirituality. I hope that spirituality is about practicing then in our both personal life and business life. You know, so thank you for taking that step and helping me choose this topic. Thank you very much.
Wonderful.